before we go to the panelists.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, I think this leads us to the possibility of a government enterprise which can be self-liquidated, and that is to target these areas that are not yet covered, maybe 30% of the Philippine geography, the so-called missionary areas. And a government entity like maybe Telo or a government corporation set up for this can be the one to initiate the setting up of the towers to be leased to the various telcos. And I think it may make money instead of the telcos being the one to fund these towers, which can be a very big burden for them. So this can be a self-liquidating. They can probably go to the DBP, ask the DBP to finance this, and then on the back-to-back lease agreement with the telcos. So this may be a self-liquidating proposition. If we want to really accelerate this, I think that's an area where the government can get into. Because, Mr. Chairman, I think we should be all aware that one of the reasons where a government entity can come in the business is when the private sector is shying away from that business for various reasons, like it may not be financially viable immediately, or they don't have the financial capacity to fund the capacity expansion, Mr. Chairman. So this is something that we can throw to the executive branch.
Thank you, Honorable Luis. Now let's hear the telcos have heard the discussions. Let's hear their point of view regarding this issue, and then after that we hear the other agencies in the executive as to where they think the broadband initiatives are headed. So unahin po natin yung mga telco representatives natin dito, if we may hear from them. Attorney Pamituhan, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. We basically agree, Your Honor, with the